The first step in the cold draw is the lubrication process, which enables the draw bench to pull tubing through smoothly. Tubes are first dipped into an acid bath to clean their surfaces, then they are dipped into a cold rinse tank before entering a lube tank. The lube is then allowed to dry. Next, one end of the tube is pointed. The point is necessary so the tube can pass into and through the die on the draw bench. The drawn over mandrel process reduces the diameter of the tube. A mandrel is pushed to the inside of the tube to control the ID in the wall, then the tube is drawn over the mandrel. This process allows the customer to specify tight tolerances on the OD, ID, or wall. Webco is able to produce drawn over mandrel tube products to a wide range of customer specified sizes and mechanical properties. After cold drawing, tubes are annealed a second time to relieve residual stresses in the material. In Webco's cold draw department, the tubing can be annealed at a wide variety of temperatures to ensure that it meets mechanical requirements. Similar to the weld mill furnace process, the tubes pass through a cooling zone after they reach the desired temperature. Then they are air-cooled before being transferred to the finishing department. In Webco's finishing department, tubes are straightened with an inline straightener that can hold customers' tightest specifications for straightness. Tubes are then tested using a variety of destructive and non-destructive testing methods. Each method ensures that the tubes meet customer and ASTM specifications. Those that do not meet standards are scrapped. The tubes are then cut to length specified by the customer. Webco's high-quality tube products are then packaged into hex bundles, providing a shipping and storage-friendly geometry that is ready to unload and put to work at your facility.